Welcome and thank you for joining the webinar today. I'm Amanda Jadrow, the Director of Portfolio Management at TRICOM. As an administrative and financial solutions provider to the staffing and consulting industry, it is our philosophy to be an active member and by staying abreast of the ever-changing marketplace. For that reason, TRICOM was pleased to launch the Industry Insider webinar series designed to share our expert knowledge and resources with our fellow staffing industry colleagues. One of our core values is to build relationships and become a leading resource to staffing and consulting firms nationwide. Our presenter today is Brad with Haley Marketing Group. Brad is passionate about helping organizations develop and implement strategic digital marketing strategies to reach defined business goals. Brad has motivated and educated more than 1,300 staffing industry members through 20-plus industry-specific conferences and webinar series. He has helped oversee the social media and content marketing strategy and comprehensive marketing execution of nearly 200 staffing and recruiting firms. While at Haley Marketing Group, he has guided the strategy and delivery of multiple industry award-winning social media campaigns. Brad oversees and develops a comprehensive social media marketing campaign for Haley Marketing Group and manages the development, the product development of Haley Marketing Group's Social Pro Service, the award-winning social media marketing solution designed specifically for the staffing and recruiting industry. Websites, social media, SEO, blogging, email marketing, PPC. For more than 20 years, Haley Marketing has served the staffing industry. Their work has won more than 65 Genius and Voice Awards from ASA, and they can help you stand out, stay top of mind, and sell more. With the national unemployment rate of 3.9%, staffing professionals need every tool possible at their disposal when recruiting and sourcing candidates. While digital marketing, direct marketing and advertising from an organizational level are more important than ever, often overlooked is the impact of your personal brand on social media can have on a candidate's decision to work with your staffing agency instead of a local or national competitor. In today's webinar session, Brad will discuss personal branding, your secret to more applications and better candidates. Our learning objectives for today are some things that you'll take away and learn throughout the presentation are how to define the keys to a successful personal brand, the three-step process of personal branding on social media, and 13 tactics to deploy on social media to generate more applications and source better candidates. If you have questions during the presentation, please utilize the Q&A or the chat feature located on the toolbar. We will have a time at the end for questions and an opportunity for you to give us your feedback on today's webinar by completing a short exit poll. With that, I will turn the floor over to Brad.
Thank you so much for the incredible introduction, Amanda. I truly appreciate you and TRICOM having me and Haley Marketing Group on the webinar series this afternoon. As Amanda discussed, I'm going to be talking about personal branding and really talking about your secret to more applications and better candidates. And as she mentioned, if you have questions throughout the presentation, please use that questions window so that those can be funneled to both of us. I would love to address any questions either during the presentation or after so that we can make sure that your questions are being answered accordingly. Today, you are you. That is truer than true. There's no one alive who is youer than you. Growing up, I was a massive Dr. Seuss fan, and I still am today. And when I think about personal branding, nothing rings truer than this quote from Dr. Seuss himself. If you think about who you are as an individual, you're unique. You have specific characteristics that make up who you are and make you different than everybody else in the world. As we look at national unemployment at 3.9%, we can cut through the clutter and we can cut through the noise and differentiate ourselves and our staffing and recruiting firms by deploying our personal branding. So throughout this presentation, I want you to constantly think about this quote. Today, you are you. That is truer than true. There's no one alive who is youer than you. But what makes you you? Jay Danzi said it best. Your smile is your logo. Your personality is your business card. And how you leave others feeling after having an experience with you becomes your trademark. If you think about offline for a second, and I know we're going to be talking about digital media and really social media recruiting. If you think about offline, how you make others feel makes up your personal brand. When an applicant comes into your office, how you interact with them, how you talk to them, how you make them feel comfortable, how you answer their questions, that makes you unique. That makes them want to come back and come to you for their next employment opportunity instead of going to your local competition. They enjoy working with you specifically. So when we think about personal branding, we really want to think about your smile, who you are as an individual, what makes you unique, and what makes you you. See, online is just an extension of who you already are. I see time and time again individuals on social media putting on this front or putting on a different persona, being someone that they're not. And what we want to do with social media is become an extension of who we are offline. Our online presence on Twitter, LinkedIn, Facebook, Instagram, maybe Snapchat or YouTube is just an extension of who we are offline. We want to continue those characteristics, our personality, our uniqueness onto social media so that when an individual comes across our page, they know who we are. They feel comfortable with who we are so that as they come into their office and start to find their next opportunity, they already feel like they're connected to you. They feel like they have some talking points with you, and it makes that awkward first conversation a lot more pleasant. So what are the keys to a successful personal brand? I've broken this down into two main points, authenticity and relatability. I had mentioned that time and time again, I see individuals putting on a front on social media. People are being not typical to who they are offline, online. Maybe it's by portraying themselves as somebody they're not. Maybe it's only showcasing the positives instead of the negatives as well. But they're not being authentic. They're not being their true selves. We want to instead be authentic, and we want to be relatable. And the reason we want to do that is, like I said a slide prior, we want to make sure that when a candidate comes into our office, that they know who we are as they open up the front door of that office building. We want them to be able to relate to us on a personal level. Maybe it's because you like professional sports teams or because you love a particular band. We want to make that first conversation, maybe that first interview, which could be a hassle for some candidates. Maybe that's where they get bottled up and they get a little nervous. We want to make that easy for them so that we can see the true individual for who they are and we can put that great individual into a great opportunity. So we want authenticity and we want relatability. And as I say that, the more detailed you can be, the more relatable you become on social media, the more detailed that you are in your profile, the more relatable you become to other individuals. So time and time again, I hear staffing professionals, I hear recruiters say that they don't want to open up on social media, or how much should I open up? What should I tell individuals? And my answer to that is tell them exactly what you would tell them offline. If a candidate came into your office and they asked you about your favorite sports team or your favorite band, would you tell them that answer? If the answer is yes, then you should also relay that on social media. If they ask about your personal life, maybe your husband or your wife, would you tell them about your kids? If the answer is yes offline, then you should also showcase that online. There's always this back and forth on LinkedIn of, oh, LinkedIn isn't Facebook. You know, save that message for Facebook. Don't save that for LinkedIn. I got married this past October, 2 months ago here, and the first thing that I did was post one of our wedding pictures. And the reason that I did that is because as I travel and I meet different individuals throughout the industry, they get to know who I am, but they also get to know who Rachel is. And in posting that picture, I'm letting my network know about key events that are happening in my life, and I'm opening up to them. I'm detailing who I am, and I'm documenting my journey, and I'm showcasing that on social media. But again, don't do anything online that you wouldn't offline. I'm not asking you to be anything other than yourself on social media. Again, we want to be authentic, and we want to be relatable. But that authenticity is a core component of it. With that said, it's time that we put the social back in social media. As a social media marketer here at Haley Marketing Group, I can admit that we have a funny way of messing up things. You know, when it comes to Facebook or LinkedIn, we're always looking for the best way to use that tool to our advantage, to drive applicants back to an available job opportunity, to drive applicants to a conversion form, or to drive them to an ebook where they can download it and we can get their information. But in 2019, I challenge you to put the social back in social media. Become human on social media. As you're looking through LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter, as you see different questions or different blog posts or different articles or news stories, share your thoughts on those pieces of content. As you see individuals who are updating their status with life events, share your comments on those as well. Put the social back in social media. Don't simply hide behind your brand and that logo, but instead use your personal brand, use who you are as an individual to grow your personal connections and ultimately funnel more candidates back to your organization. So again, this is personal branding, your secret to more applications and better candidates. As I mentioned at the beginning of the presentation, if you do have questions throughout this presentation, I ask that you use the Q&A window. Amanda's going to funnel all those together for me, and then we're going to go through those at the end of the presentation, should you have any questions. I want to start with the three steps to developing your personal brand on social media. The first is profile development. The second is joining the conversation. And the third is starting the conversation. Now, as you see these three steps in front of you, I want to stress that they are in numeric order for a specific reason. The first thing we want to do is develop our profile. We want to make sure that our profile is authentic. It is who we are. It is a true representation of who we are. And it is an extension of our offline selves in an online platform. From there, we want to join the conversation that's already happening around us. There's nothing worse than joining a conversation or being in a public forum and having a conversation with an individual and having somebody else walk up to you and just start a different conversation. Instead, we want to join the conversation. We don't want to start a conversation from the very beginning. We want to see what's already going on around us, and we want to add value when we can. Once we've added that value and we've earned the trust of our community, then we want to start the conversation. As we're starting the conversation, we're looking at different tactics, and I'm going to walk through those in a moment. But again, I want to stress that the steps of this process are in numeric order. We want to develop our profile. We want to make sure it's a true representation of our authentic self. From there, we want to join the conversation, and then we want to start and begin the conversation. So let's talk about profile development. The first is owning your name. LinkedIn and Facebook make this incredibly easy. As you set up personal accounts on LinkedIn and Facebook, you're asked to start those with your name, Brad Biley, for example. From there, you can own that name, own your name, and own that profile. Where it gets a little tricky is places like Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, where you can create handles. So at Brad Biley. What I would encourage you to do is own your name across social media. Own at Brad Biley. Own at Joe Smith. Because what happens is as you add your name and you own your name, you add a discoverability factor to social media. So if you meet somebody at a job fair, at a career fair, at a local networking event, they don't have to look for Brad337 on Twitter. They have my business card, they see my name, they look for Brad Biley. Own your name. Don't own an alias, don't own anything with extra characters, but instead own your name. Now you might be thinking, Brad, I have a very generic name. And let's say, you know, Joe Smith, something where there might be 1,000 Joe Smiths in the world. Joe Smith is already taken on Twitter. What should I do? Well, in that case, I would recommend what a few of us have done at Haley Marketing Group. In develop some sort of naming convention that is consistent with your organization. So David at Haley, for example, Michelle at Haley, for example. Think about your organization and build a Twitter handle around your name, at organization. And again, what that helps you do is develop your personal brand while also tying in the organization and staying on a professional level. So again, always try to own your name. If your name is already taken, think of some very findable alternative to that, but stay away from having anything too intricate because we want to be able to be found when searched on social media. The next step in developing your profile is completing that profile. On LinkedIn, this is considered all-star status. And what happens on LinkedIn is that you never quite get to 100% complete. Though you can try and try and continuously develop that profile, you never get to 100% because LinkedIn always wants you to come back in and tweak something. What I would challenge you to do is start with your favorite social platform. If it's LinkedIn, start with LinkedIn. This afternoon, tomorrow afternoon, go through and complete that profile in its entirety. Put in your biography, put in the About Me section, put in your work history, your schooling history if you think it's still relevant. Put in any sort of extra activities that you've participated in. Any other elements that make you and make you unique, add those to your profile. But complete that profile to all-star status. I want to back up for a second and say start where you're most comfortable. Marketer after marketer, when I look on social media, I see individuals preaching the latest and greatest trends. And to me, that doesn't make a whole lot of sense. See, I would rather encourage you to start where you're most comfortable than tell you that you have to be on Twitter or that you have to be on Facebook or you have to be on Instagram. See, if you're most comfortable with LinkedIn, start with LinkedIn. If you're most comfortable with Instagram, complete your Instagram profile. And then once you're comfortable there, move on to the next platform. We're going to focus on small wins. We're going to focus on starting with building your profile and developing your profile, but doing so in a way that starts at its core foundation of owning your name, then completing the profile that you are most comfortable with. And as a bit of a disclaimer, as I'm going through these steps, at no point am I trying to overwhelm anybody. I want to break this down at its very foundation, but it's also in a way that is very strategic in the sense of start where you are most comfortable. If I go into a tactic on Twitter and you've never set up a Twitter account, that's fine. Everything's going to be okay. I'm going to share tips from every platform, but think about where you're most comfortable and then move on from there. The next step in developing your profile is taking a professional headshot. The reason we want to take a professional headshot is because we want to add authenticity to our social profiles. And what happens when we take a professional headshot is, A, we put our best foot forward and our best self forward, but we also want to take a professional headshot that showcases who we are so that as individuals see us at career fairs or networking events, they see us and they can recognize our personal brand, which is our face and who we are, what makes us us. See, if you have a professional headshot, when you go to that networking event and somebody passes you by, they might recognize that face from LinkedIn. If your LinkedIn profile is you wearing a hat or a baseball cap or maybe a hoodie because you used a great picture that you think you look great in, but it's cropped from a backyard barbecue, it's not a true representation of who you are. It doesn't add into that discoverability factor. So we want people to understand that if they have your business card in their pocket, they put it on their desk and they search Brad Biley. One, they want to be able to find the name, but then they want to remember you. They want to see that headshot. They want to say, yeah, that's Brad. I remember that person. That also helps if there's other individuals in the world with your name. Maybe they don't remember what company you're with, but they recognize the name. If they can be triggered by your personal brand, again, your face and who you are, it makes it much easier to connect with individuals on social media. So I challenge you and I encourage you to add that professional headshot. And that doesn't need to be somebody coming in with expensive gear into your office, but it could be you standing in front of a blank wall and having somebody take a great picture with their iPhone or their Galaxy device. It could be somebody taking a great picture on an Android phone, but we want to do so in a professional setting. We want to put our best representation of ourselves on those platforms. Link your company. So on social media, I encourage you to link your company to your profile. And there's a couple different ways to do that based on the platform. But the reason we want to do that is, as we're trying to source better candidates and generate more applications, by growing our personal brand, by developing our profile, the main goal is that we can build trust, we can build relationships, and ultimately we can funnel candidates to the right pages where they can apply for available opportunities, or where they can learn about the organization, they can then go to the website, and they can apply to available opportunities. But by linking your company, you add a layer of credibility, you add a layer of who you are as an individual, and you link your organization. So on Facebook, on LinkedIn, you can connect the company profile to your profile by saying that's where you work, that's your place of employment, or your work history. But on Twitter, what I would encourage you to do is to have Haley Marketing, in this example, in your biography or in your 160-character bio. For you specifically, think about the organization that you're with. And what you want to do is make sure that that company name is in the bio of your Twitter account. And the reason you want to do that and not the at symbol of the account is because if somebody searches for Haley Marketing Group, again, in this example, and in most instances throughout the presentation, I will refer to myself or Haley Marketing just because that's what you'll see on the slides, and it'll be easy for me to relate to and explain, but please supplement in your name, your organization, in place of that. If somebody goes to Twitter and they search for Haley Marketing, this is what shows up, or at least what showed up for me as I was finalizing the slides over the past week or so. So as somebody's looking for the organization, now they're seeing our team. They can connect with us on a personal level. If you were to have at Haley Marketing in there and somebody searched for Haley Marketing, it might not show up. See, Twitter's using certain keywords and different keyword parameters to showcase what they see on this screen. So while we're growing our personal brands, we also add in that layer of company branding as well. We're now connected to the organization so that if somebody searches for XYZ staffing, they see you. They now know that you work there and you can help them should they ever have a need for their employment opportunity. So again, connect your profile on LinkedIn, on Facebook. You can do so by adding that as your work history. But on Twitter, what I would encourage you to do is add the organization's name in your bio. Again, with developing your profile, we're going to talk about growing your community. As we grow the community, what can we do? On Facebook and on Twitter, Facebook and LinkedIn, what I would encourage you to do is look for specific roles that you're constantly trying to fill and use advanced search techniques to look for those individuals. Let's walk through LinkedIn here and let me break this down for you. So let's say you're looking for engineers in Denver. You typically fill engineer roles throughout the greater Denver area. As you're recruiting and as you're looking for those individuals, and I was just in Denver at the Colorado Staffing Association's annual conference in October, I want to say their unemployment rate's around 2%, so incredibly low, which means at this rate, we're just looking for passive job seekers. We're looking for individuals that are looking for the next opportunity, the next great opportunity that'll take their career to the next level. So with that said, what we want to do is we want to look for engineers, and again, this is in LinkedIn search right at the top of the window. You'll type in engineer. Under that, you'll hit the drop-down where it says people. You'll hit that drop-down. You'll select people. The second tab over there, you're going to type in your location. So if you're in the Denver area and you're looking for engineers, you type in Denver. If you're where I currently am and you're looking for engineers in Buffalo, New York, you would type in Buffalo, New York. Then, as we shift over, you're going to look for secondary connections. A secondary connection is somebody that you're connected to through somebody else. So a friend of a friend. So if Amanda is connected to somebody and I'm connected to Amanda, they would be a secondary connection to me. They're a friend of a friend. What we want to then do is click search. And what happens is LinkedIn shows us everybody in the greater Denver area that is a friend of a friend to somebody that you're connected with that also has engineer in their title. I would go through and I would do this sort of like a workout program. Maybe Monday, Wednesday, Friday, every morning you come in here for 10 minutes with your morning cup of coffee and you do a search parameter like this for a role that you're trying to actively fill and you click connect with 15 to 20 people every other day. Now, this might not be somebody that's ready to jump ship and find their next opportunity right now, but we've already developed our profile. You know, we have that headshot. We have that profile completed as best as we can. We have this About Us section that's built out. So if Randall Brown connected to me and he sees that I'm a top engineering recruiter in Denver and he goes to look for his next opportunity, we're hoping that he comes to me instead of my local competition. We're hoping that he comes to you. Because now, as we connect with all these individuals, we go through the remainder of this presentation and growing your personal brand of joining the conversation, starting the conversation. So first, we want to grow that network. We want to make sure that we're connecting with people on a consistent basis. We want to make sure that we're always looking on LinkedIn and we're sorting by these titles, location, and secondary connections. On Twitter, I would encourage you to follow local organizations and individuals directly on that platform. And again, if you've never used Twitter before but you're active on LinkedIn, start with LinkedIn. Don't let this tactic overwhelm you, but if you're active on Twitter, this is what I encourage you to do. So if you're looking for individuals in the Denver area, what I would do is look for local food trucks, local establishments, local maybe bars and restaurants. I've even at one point was advocating for Little Loop and little football teams and minor league baseball teams or even different local associations and organizations, chambers of commerce. Why you want to look at that local level is because anybody that's following those accounts is going to be from the area. If you follow a team like the Denver Broncos and you're sourcing engineers in Denver, you're looking for engineers in Denver, and you follow a team like the Broncos, and you go through and you start to follow people that they're following or people that are following them, you could be following people from across the world because they're such a large name. So what you want to do is really break that down. You want to follow smaller accounts. You want to look at people that are very localized to the area that you're trying to find great candidates in, and then follow people that are following those accounts. From there, again, you're going to follow these local organizations. You're going to click on the account, and you're going to start to follow people that follow that account because they're local to the area. We're going to use this tactic, and again, just like that workout program, every Monday, Wednesday, Friday, maybe it's only every Tuesday and Thursday, start with what you're comfortable with. Go through LinkedIn and connect with 20 to 25 individuals. Go through Twitter and do the exact same. But start to grow that network so that as we go into steps 2 and 3 of the 3-step process, we have an audience to talk to. I'll tell you specifically myself on LinkedIn, I deployed the strategy that I talked about the slide prior at the beginning of the year. To date, I've grown my account to almost 11,000 different connections from throughout the staffing and recruiting industry specifically. And what that's done and what that's helped generate is different inbound sales opportunities for Haley Marketing Group. It's also helped me on a personal level speak at more local organizations and more national associations and different conferences. But it's all because I'm going through and sourcing the right individuals and connecting with the right people. So I'm a proven advocate for this strategy. I've seen it work myself. I've seen it work for Haley Marketing Group. And I strongly encourage you to do the same with your personal brands on social. So we talked about developing your profile. We talked about going through and first owning your name. From there, you're going to complete your profile with a complete headshot and a professional headshot. Then you're going to go through and you're going to connect with individuals, whether that's on LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter. You're going to go through and you're going to connect with very targeted individuals in your local area. You're going to grow that network. You're going to showcase your best self. When putting through your bio and when you're really putting together that profile, make sure that it's authentic. Again, we want online to be an extension of who we are offline. We don't want to put on a persona. We don't want to put up a front. We want to be who we are online as the same as we are offline. Because when somebody gets to know us, whether it's offline or online, we want that to be an extension of who we are. It's just in a different platform. Once we develop that profile, we move to step 2 of the process, which is joining the conversation. I had an interesting conversation with a local musician a couple years ago. I used to play guitar throughout Buffalo, New York. And I was at a gig one night, and somebody came up to me, and they said, Brad, he had known what I do for a living, really, in marketing and social marketing. And he had said, Brad, I need some advice. On Twitter, day after day, people reach out and they ask me questions, or they comment and they ask different things. Should I be responding to those questions? And I looked at them and I said, if we were sitting here right now and you kept talking to me and all I did was look at my phone or look the other way and ignore you, would you keep talking or would you go somewhere else? And I promise you, I saw the light bulb turn on. He knew then that all of these potential people that were talking to him were potential fans, potential people that could buy his merchandise or buy his CDs or become fans of him. In the same respect, if people are reaching out to you on a personal level or reaching out on a professional level or reaching out to your company pages on social media, joining the conversation and joining that question, that comment, is the best way to get started on social media. We want to be seen as somebody that's always listening, is here for the community, and is here for that end user. Because ultimately, if you don't answer that question, they're going to go to somebody else who will answer that question. So we want to be the resource that they're looking for when they're looking for it. We talk about joining the conversation. I would encourage you to join LinkedIn and Facebook groups based on location and industry. Let me break that down. On LinkedIn, if you go into search and you click on, let's type in Denver again, for example, and then you, instead of typing in or clicking on people, like we did in the past example, you click on groups, it will show you all of the groups and communities that exist on LinkedIn with the keyword Denver. Now let's say that you wanted to look for engineers in Denver or manufacturing in Denver, supply chain Denver. Looking at different keyword strings and different keyword variables will render different groups of individuals who are talking about that given industry in that given space that you can join that group and you can join the conversation. Now, what I would encourage you to do is just that, join the conversation. Don't enter that group and just post job after job after job, but instead join the group and add value. If somebody's asking a question and you know the answer, answer it. If you don't know the answer but you know somebody that can, tag them in the comment and ask them to answer the question. Be of value, be a resource to these individuals so that as they learn who you are, because again, we've developed our profile in step one, as they learn who you are, they now know who they can come to for more information or for their next opportunity. We can do the exact same on Facebook. Look for, again, a specific city. Look for jobs in that city. It's one of my favorite things to do right now, and where we're seeing the most value at Haley Marketing Group is deploying different tactics in specialized groups and localized groups built around jobs in city, employment in city, city, jobs, different strings like that. But what we're trying to do is join these groups, and again, we're trying to add value. So we're not joining and just saying, hey, here's another job, here's another job, here's another job. But again, we're listening. We're waiting, and then on behalf of our clients, we're going in and we're saying, hey, Brad, it looks like you're looking for an opportunity in Denver. XYZ Staffing has 15 available jobs on their job board. I'm sure there's one that's perfect for you. Why don't you check out the link, and if you're ready to apply, you can apply so right online. So looking at different groups based on city, based on jobs, based on industry, really refine that search and join the conversation. Another thing you can do, and I have a screen here just of Facebook, but join the conversation directly in your timeline and in your newsfeed. So when you log into LinkedIn or Facebook or Twitter, the first thing that you'll see is what everybody else has been posting. If you can answer any questions, if you can add any value as you see those come through, I encourage you to do so. Even if it's just a post from somebody that you've met who has some exciting news to share. Clicking like and saying congratulations goes a long way. We want to be authentic. Think again if that individual told you some great news offline. If you were having a cup of coffee and somebody told you about a real great personal achievement that they had, you would congratulate them. You would have that small talk. You would have that conversation. We want to make sure we're doing so on social as well. So don't just look in groups, but also look directly in that timeline, in that newsfeed, and add value when you can. Follow hashtags on Twitter. So if we're joining the conversation and we want to get involved on Twitter, what we can do is look at very specific hashtags, or we can look in search at different keyword strings and different keyword parameters. What that's going to show us is individuals who are all talking about the same thing. So let's say we want to look at example four. You're going to a local job fair, and they have a very specific hashtag. Maybe it's the organization or an association. So I'll use the Colorado Staffing Association just because I know that. So CSA. So maybe it's CSA jobs is the hashtag, for example, just out of an example here. Follow that hashtag the days leading up to the conference, the days leading up to the networking event, the job fair. Follow that hashtag. Listen for people that are talking. Maybe there's individuals saying that they can't wait. There's individuals saying that they hope they find their next job opportunity at this job fair. Maybe there's people that are saying, hey, I'm graduating college soon, can't wait to check out hashtag CSA jobs. By following that, what we can do is join the conversation. Hey, Brad, it's great to hear that you're excited about the upcoming job fair. We'll be there. I'll be there. We'd love to chat for 10 minutes. Do you think you could pencil us in at 2:30? Join that conversation. Reply to that individual. So instead of just sharing that you'll be there on your personal Twitter, join the conversation. Listen to what others are saying and then have that dialogue, have that communication. So we've developed our profile. We've joined the conversation. Now it's time to actually start the conversation. And this question I get time and time again from different clients or different individuals that we consult with here at Haley Marketing of, well, Brad, I get it. We set up our profile. I have my headshot. I can put in my bio. I know what I've done throughout my work history. Now what? What am I going to say? What do I talk about on social media? Because I got a busy day. You know, we have different interviews. We're sourcing candidates. The wheels are turning over here. Now I need to sit down for 20 minutes and find something to post on LinkedIn. This is my blueprint of where I would start the conversation and what I would post on social media. The first is to start with what you already know and make it personal. As I've said, online is an extension of offline. Showcase your wins, showcase who you are, showcase your work history, showcase anything that you're proud of, and also showcase anything that the organization that you work for is proud of. I have a couple examples on the screen here. When you look at my social media, whether it's LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter, you're going to see a lot of Haley Marketing Group, the speaking opportunities that I'm blessed to attend and the speeches that I'm lucky enough to deliver. You'll see a lot of lacrosse because I'm passionate about the Rochester Nighthawks and the lacrosse team nearby. You'll see a lot of Gary Vee and motivational quotes and different content from him. And then you'll see a lot of me and my wife here because I'm passionate about our relationship as well. See, I like to make social media personal because what happens then, and I know that Shelly at Tricom can attest to this, when I see Shelly at different conferences, the first thing she usually asks about is Rachel, or she'll ask about how things are going. So we have that personal connection now already so that there's no awkwardness in that first, hey, how are things or how's everything been? It's right back to being friends and having that conversation. It makes it so much easier when you meet somebody offline. So what we want to do here is we want to be authentic. We want to be relatable. We want to showcase who we are so that as we meet different individuals, again, at job fairs, networking events, they feel as though they already know us and they have a talking point. They can talk about what they've seen on your feed. They could talk about that, and you can make that awkward first conversation a lot more pleasant. Next, I would encourage you to document your journey. So there's a difference between documenting and creating content. Documenting is physically taking pictures of what you're seeing, posting what you're doing, posting the events that you're attending, posting the roles that you're trying to fill, and being very strategic in the actual opportunities that you're trying to fill. But document your journey. And I'm not saying post a picture of every lunch that you have or every dinner that you have, but document your day-to-day, document what it's like around the office or what you're doing. Again, the assignments that you're trying to fill, the different individuals. If you're at career fairs or networking events, document that. And not just documenting it while you're there. Document the prep leading up to it, the post-conference afterwards, the post-event afterwards, but documenting that. Once you've documented everything, then you can start to create content. And I would encourage you to create written blog content. And we're going to start with blog content. And if you're thinking, Brad, I don't know what to write about, what should I blog about? I would start a blog based on answering questions that you never want to answer again. If you think about questions that you get time after time from candidates, think about the answers, the questions that you get, answer them on LinkedIn Pulse or on your organization's blog, and then the next time you get that question, you can send that to a candidate instead. You can save yourself the 30 minutes and the headache of having to answer that question once more, and you can send them a great resource that drives them back to either your personal LinkedIn page, the organization's company page, or their website, but blog to answer questions. And then as you're blogging, as you're creating that written content, you're going to share that on social media. You're going to share that through your platforms because you want to amplify that message. You want to make sure more people read it and more people see it. Blogging to become a thought leader. So you've written content around the common questions that you get day after day. Now we want to blog to become a thought leader. And when I say thought leadership, really what I mean is blogging based on your specific industry, your niche, and blogging to showcase yourself as the top staffing specialist or recruiter in your local market. Showcase your insight and answer the common pain points of candidates in your local area. And if it's not their pain points, maybe it's the employment status of your local area. What's national unemployment in your local area? How do you see that projecting through the 2019? What can you do specifically to help candidates that are looking to take the next step in their career? Maybe somebody's happy where they are. Why should they take the risk of finding their next opportunity if they're already happy in their current role? What besides salary would entice somebody to leave their role? Blogging and writing content, creating content, allows you to develop a level of thought leadership so that as individuals read that content, they learn more about who you are, the value that you provide, and then should they have another question, they know to come to you first instead of going to your local competition or national competition in your backyard as well. So we're going to create content, we're going to blog to answer questions, and we're going to blog to become a thought leader. Starting the conversation, I would encourage you to share content through your personal social media platforms 3 times every week. It's your social media workout. You're going to log in every Monday, Wednesday, Friday and connect with 20 people on LinkedIn using the tactics I discussed. You're going to log in every Tuesday and Thursday and connect with 20 people on Twitter using, again, the tactics that I discussed. Then maybe every Monday, Wednesday, Friday, before you leave the office for the day, you're going to share content 3 times every week. And what content are you going to share? Well, if you're blogging, you can share your own content in different ways. If you're not blogging and you're not writing that content, maybe your organization is. And if your organization is blogging, you can share those posts. Maybe on Monday you share a new blog post. On Wednesday you share an available job opportunity that you're actively trying to fill. And then on Friday, you share something fun from around the local area or local events that are coming up in your local area that can showcase you as an expert in your local market. So it's local events that are going on Saturday or Sunday. Or maybe on Friday, you share a Inc. or a Forbes article. But get into the habit of sharing 3 times every week and providing value to your audience. And the reason we want to do that again is because as we attract our audience through great content, they funnel to your profile, they learn who you are, and they understand, hey, this is Brad, this is what he talks about. If I have any questions, I know to go to Brad for that answer. Or if I need my next employment opportunity, to go to Brad because he's well-versed in the local market, in employment in Denver, Colorado, and I know that he's the person I have to talk to should I ever need my next job. So we're going to share content 3 times every week. Again, talking about starting the conversation. Then the last tip is pressing record and filming video content. And I included this last, and I thought about including it first. And the reason I did so is because video content, in my opinion, is having the largest impact in terms of reach, impressions, and viewability on social right now. Video content is getting a nice push in terms of distribution right now on LinkedIn. We're seeing it on Facebook as well. But I decided to put it last because, in my opinion, it's also the biggest hurdle for people to jump over. For some reason, it's a lot easier to publish a piece of written content than it is to get in front of a camera, see a red recording light, and actually share your thoughts and post that on social media. I would challenge you in 2019 to get comfortable pressing record and distributing social media content in the forms of video content. And to start, I would encourage you to take 3 to 5 videos that never make it out of your phone or never make it onto social media. If you're not comfortable in front of a camera, you're not comfortable talking in front of a camera or recording video content, record 3 to 5 videos. And again, we're talking about, again, showcasing our expertise. So maybe it's available job opportunities. It's something that you've written on a blog that you're now turning into a video. You're answering candidate questions on video. So how do I improve my resume? How do I select the best references? What do I do if I'm happy with my job now but I'm looking for the next opportunity? Answering those common questions just on video form. And what you're going to do with the first 3 to 5 is you're going to look at them, and I know I do it, so I would think everybody else is going to do it, but you're going to be overly critical of those first 3 to 5. And that's okay, because after that, that critical phase ends, and we actually start posting content. But watch those first 3 to 5, learn from your mistakes. Maybe it's your body posture, or it's certain ways that you say different letters. Think about it and actually learn from what you're watching back and use that education to improve as you move forward. But I would encourage you in 2019 to press record and become comfortable with video content, because I'm passionate about the thought of video content continuing to grow in importance, and I don't want to see anybody left behind as that continues to grow. But again, I do want to say that I put this last on the presentation because I know that it is the biggest hurdle to overcome. So start with where you're most comfortable. Again, start with LinkedIn if you're most comfortable with LinkedIn. Throughout the presentation, to recap here, we talked about personal branding and really your secret to more applications and better candidates. I do want to mention that if you want to download the ebook that was inspired from this presentation, you can go to bit.ly/branding19 to download your copy completely free. I do want to mention that branding has to be all capital when you go to that URL, so it's bit.ly/branding19 to download the ebook that was inspired from this presentation. To reiterate, personal branding is your secret to more applications and better candidates. And when we think about personal branding in 2019, it follows a 3-step process. We need to develop our profile. We need to make sure that we are owning our name, we're completing that profile, we're adding a professional headshot, we're growing our audience because we're actively connecting with individuals. We're growing our personal brand and our personal profiles. And when we're doing so, we're doing it in an authentic and a relatable way. We're continuing our offline personal selves into an online platform. Online is an extension of who we are offline. And we're just continuing who we are already offline, online, onto social media. Once we've developed that profile, we're going to join the conversation. We're going to listen, and we're going to wait for people to ask questions. And when we can add value, we're going to do so. We're going to join the conversation in LinkedIn groups, in Facebook groups. We're going to look at different Twitter hashtags, and we're going to join that conversation. We're also just going to look right at the social platform itself. We're going to look at the newsfeed. We're going to look at our timelines. And when people ask questions or when they have great updates, we're going to join the conversation, and we're going to offer our input and our opinion on those topics. We're going to do so because as we join the conversation, we earn trust, we earn the respect of our network, of those individuals, where we can then start the conversation. And when we look to start the conversation, we're going to do so by first showcasing who we are. We're going to make it personal. Then we're going to document the journey. We're going to document what we're doing on a day-to-day basis. Then we're going to create content. So we're going to document, and then we're going to create. And if we're going to create blog content, we're going to do so first by answering questions that we get time after time that we don't want to answer again, because we're going to save ourselves time in the long run, and we're also going to provide great resources to candidates. As we start the conversation, we're going to look at sharing content 3 times every week. because, again, we want to build our credibility on these platforms so that as candidates look for their next opportunity, they know to come to you instead of local competition. And then the last thing we're going to do in 2019 is also arguably the most important, and we're going to press record. If you're not comfortable on video and you're not comfortable with video content, take the first 3 to 5 to be overly critical with yourself. That's okay. We're going to take the first 3 to 5. We're going to record them. We're going to look at them back, maybe show them to a colleague or somebody that you work with, a friend or a family member. Ask for that feedback. But after the 5th one, we're going to go live with it, and we're going to let our audience dictate what is good content. We're going to provide those great resources to our candidates. And then from there, we're going to go right back to step 1. So we're going to develop our profile, join the conversation, start the conversation. As we've started the conversation, we're constantly tweaking our profile. We're making sure that as new achievements happen in our lives, we're updating our profile. We're constantly joining the conversation, and we're consistently starting the conversation. But we're listening more than we're talking. Just like any conversation offline, we're joining that conversation before we start the conversation. Again, if you'd like to download the ebook that was inspired by this presentation, you can go to bit.ly/branding19. And again, branding has to be in capitals to get to that landing page where you can download your copy completely free. Amanda, Tricom, I want to thank you both for having me this afternoon. And if there are any questions, I'm happy to stay on the line to answer those for you. Or my email is on the screen as well if you would rather reach out one-to-one via email. But thank you all very much for having me this afternoon. And again, Amanda and Tricom, I truly appreciate having the opportunity to share my personal branding presentation with your audience.
Brad, thank you so much. I will go ahead and open up the poll and open up the floor for questions. For anyone who has questions, please go ahead and submit them now. A couple questions have come in. Also put up our contact information here. Can you tell me how long should a recording, video recording content be?
It's a great question. My answer, and I'm sorry if it sounds like I'm dancing around the answer, but the answer truly is as long as you need to answer the question. So video content, myself and Matt Lozar from our team, we both create video content here at Haley Marketing Group. Matt sticks to under a minute. He considers his presentations, they go by the Matt minute. So his video content has to be under a minute. Mine is more long in the form of like 3 to 5 minutes, but it follows a very specific path. And when you're creating video content, instead of looking at a time limit, I would challenge you and encourage you to think about how long will it take for me to answer the question so that I'm not wasting the individual's time, but also providing great value. If this presentation could have been condensed into 15 minutes and we could have really got through it quicker, I would have rather had that instead of really stretching it out. But we stuck to a time limit that got all of the value, everything that I wanted to share, and was very specific in that. So I would encourage you to do the same.
And as you're posting on whatever social media platform you choose, these are posts under your own personal account rather than a company account. Do you have any suggestions on how to, kind of cover both areas?
Yeah, that's a great question. And actually, Amanda, I'm going to ask you to stay on the line here. Earlier this year, I gave a presentation called The Roadmap, and it's the step-by-step guide to recruiting on social media. I gave that for the Tricom audience, I believe, in March, and all of the webinars are recorded. So if anybody on the line is interested in watching that presentation, that goes through really how to recruit on social media through a company level. This presentation is geared towards personal branding, but Amanda, if you could, and you'll probably know the path to where those webinars are hosted, would love for you to share that as well, because that's definitely recorded for the Tricom audience.
Yeah, absolutely. We do record them. They're all on our website. It is at tricom.com. It's under the Industry Insiders webinar tab. You'll find all of our past recordings that are available for you to view at your convenience, and they are also posted on our YouTube channel. So those are great resources to use. So definitely want to post under your personal brand as well as a company brand or follow the company brand. Those would be good suggestions. Is that correct?
Absolutely. Yeah. And I'm a big proponent of personal branding and how growing up an individual's brand can strengthen the organization's brand. So as you grow your own personal branding, it leads to a series of opportunities that ultimately grow the organization. So the whole premise here is growing you as an individual so that you can source better candidates and really land more applications on a personal level. But if you're also interested and you're listening now and you're interested in growing your organization's brand on social media, I would encourage you to watch the roadmap, which is the step-by-step guide to recruiting on social media from an organizational standpoint.
On your personal accounts, how do you strike an appropriate work and personal balance in your online perception? Do you have any suggestions on specific content that should be geared towards like a Facebook versus a LinkedIn, or do you not recommend that? Also a question just regarding friending people in your personal life versus business life on different platforms.
So my personal stance is I connect with anybody and everybody because you never know where that next opportunity is going to come from. With 3.9% unemployment and sourcing candidates through social media, I don't think that we have the opportunity really to screen who we're connecting with, because if we connect with, let's say just myself, you connect with Brad Biley on social and you're posting content about available opportunities in Buffalo, even though I'm not looking for a job, I might know somebody that is. So you should always connect and continue growing your personal brands on social, because as you're sharing content, as you're joining the conversation, you're getting in front of more people and you're showcasing your messaging. So I would encourage connecting with anybody and everybody because it leads to a lot of opportunity. The question of, well, what do I share and where are my boundaries, I think is a good one. Really, in my opinion, it comes down to what you would be comfortable sharing with somebody you met at a networking event. That should also be carried over to social media. So if you are meeting somebody and you're okay talking about, like I said, I share about myself and Rachel on my personal accounts on social. I talk about sports. I talk about a lot about social media and recruiting and how to generate more applications through social media because I know my audience is actually listening about that. Think about what you're most comfortable doing and then go from there. Don't push yourself any further than what you would be comfortable sharing with somebody at a networking event.
Okay. And again, the contact information is on the screen. If you have any specific questions that you'd like to take offline, feel free to reach out to Brad directly. As we're wrapping up the session today, Brad, did you have any final thoughts or comments that you'd like to share with the audience today?
Yeah, really my final takeaway here when it comes to personal branding would be to start with where you're most comfortable. So if you're going to invest into personal branding through social media and using that as a tool to generate more applications in 2019, start on a platform that you're comfortable with. If it's LinkedIn, start there. If you absolutely love Twitter or Instagram, start there. Don't listen to the experts that will say that you have to be in a given spot. Start where you're most comfortable and then go from there. Start with those small wins and those small, really feel-good moments on the platform that you're most comfortable with, and then move to those more challenging platforms that you're not comfortable with. That would really be my biggest takeaway here.
Wonderful. Well, thank you so much for sharing your knowledge on personal branding, your secret to more applications and better candidates. Also like to thank our participants for taking time out of their busy days to join us for this webinar topic. Again, we will have a recording of this presentation as well as past presentations on our website at trackem.com under the Industry Insider webinar series. It's in our resources tab. Thank you again for your participation and watch for information on upcoming webinar sessions. Thank you so much. Have a great day, everyone.